Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, Ummatul Muslimin. So inshallah today we'll be looking at the 21st juz of the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this portion of the Quran speaks about, you know, a common belief that was predominant in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. As we know, the Quraysh, majority of them were they that believed and worshipped idols. But even then too, they recognized a supreme being and a supreme deity. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention to this in the Quran that وَلَا إِن سَأَلْتَهُمْ مَنْ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. If you ask them who created the heavens, who created the earth, you know, who created the sun, the moon, even they will tell you that it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who has created it. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked them that then where are you people losing the plot? You know, what is there? What is difficult to understand? As we know, that they believed in idols and they believed that these idols were actually intermediaries between them and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But our faith is such that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made it that each and every single one of us doesn't need an intermediary to interact with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Each and every one of us are able to interact with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on a direct basis. This is the beauty of our deen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the very same juz of the Quran makes mention of a surah, that is Surah Rum, named after the Romans. And this was due to them being mentioned in this portion or this portion of the Quran or this surah of the Quran. And you know, this is one of the prophecies and the miracles of the Quran, that the Quran spoke about something foreshadowing, you know, an event to come. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we know, His words and His kalam is the truth. And exactly like how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had described it, that's exactly how it turned out in the end. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, now, the question is, what was the incident behind it? And it goes as follows that there were two superpowers of those days, and one was the Persian Empire and the Byzantinian Empire, the Romans of the Byzantinian Empire. Now, the Romans of the Byzantinian Empire were predominantly people of the scriptures that would follow, you know, Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam, Sayyidina Musa. The Quran makes mention to them as Ahlul Kitab, the people of the book of the scriptures. And the Persian empires were predominantly mushrikeen, people that would worship other deities besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And more specifically, they were fire worshippers. So what happened was, when they would go to war, naturally the Quraysh, the idolaters, the polytheists in Mecca would side with the Persian Empire, those that were mushrikeen. And you find the Muslims being part of, you know, the Abrahamic faith family, they would side with the people of the books, and that was the Roman Empire, the Romans of the Byzantine Empire. And It so happened that the Roman Empire were defeated, and this was somewhat of a setback to the Muslims. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informed them that in a few years to come, namely 9 years to come, the Roman Empire again will be dominant, and they will, you know, win the war over their enemies, the Persian Empire. And subhanallah, within a few years, you find that the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came true, and the Roman Empire was triumphant and the Persian Empire was defeated. So this was a sense of rejoice. You know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَيَوْمَ إِذٍ يَفْرَحُ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ, that on that day, the believers will be rejoicing. And it happened so that when they won the war, it was a sense of pleasure, and the Muslims began to rejoice over the victory. So this was one of the miracles of the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this very same juz, Surah Luqman, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which was named after this individual that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had granted immense wisdom. And you know, usually you find his books and the different advices that he's given, you know, he's normally termed as Luqman Hakim, Luqman the wise. But subhanallah, in this chapter, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of the advices that he had given to his son. Now, you know, think of it in today's time. What advice do we give our children? You know, we speak about, you know, their life. And it's always in an academic sense, that when you go out to study or when you go out to work, you know, things like that, things of that nature. But subhanallah, Luqman Hakim, Luqman the wise, gives advice to his son saying, Ya bunayya in taku in mithqala dharratin, Ya bunayya innaha in taku mithqala. What's the... Ya bunayya innaha in taku mithqala habbatin min khardalin fatakun fi sakhra. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaking about his wisdom and how he is the knower of everything. Sayyidina Luqman alayhi salam tells him that if a person has to do anything that is as small as a mustard seed, let it be in the middle of a rock, let it be in the skies, let it be on the earth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring that forward on the day of judgment. Why? Inna Allaha latifun khabir. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is informed, is well informed of every subtle thing that takes place on the face of this earth. So, you know, Luqman alayhi salam, or Luqman Hakim, Luqman the wise, would advise his children in terms of deen, in terms of faith and religion and Islam. And it shows us for them, Islam and faith came first. You know, regarding the Sahaba Ridwanullah ta'ala alayhim ajma'in, you know, it mentions that when the Sahabi was about to pass away, and people looked at him and looked at his family and the daughters that he had left behind, and looked at him and said, you know what, you're not leaving anything behind for your family. And he said that I have left the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with them. If they are worthy of it, the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will guide them. And if they are not worthy of it, then they don't deserve anything. So for them, religion and faith came first. We ask ourselves, what comes first in our life? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the next surah, Surah Sajda, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of a very, you know, unique verse. And this speaks about certain people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had granted, you know, the ability to wake up for tahajjud salah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that these people, their sides, when we sleep on our sides, their sides stay away from the mattresses. In other words, they, in the part of the night that most of us will recite to bed and retire to bed for rest, these people awaken and they pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that there is no soul that has knowledge of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has kept for them in lieu of their service and their ibadah in this world, the ibadah that they would do. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention that qurratu a'yun, that this will be a sense, a means of the coolness of their eyes, that what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has kept for them. We make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He makes us amongst them. In the next surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Surah Ahzab, that is named after one of the battles, the famous battles of Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the behavior of the mushrikeen, and those people that, you know, outwardly would claim to have sided with the Muslims, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knew the true quality of their heart. And subhanallah, you know, it's a very well-known fact that whatever a person tries, a person, no matter how hard you try to hide something in your heart, the day will come where whatever is hidden in your heart will become apparent and people will find out. And subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention that these people all along were deceiving the believers, saying that they are believers. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knew the true intention in their heart. And when it came time to put their words to action, you find they began to make excuses. And they would say such things just with the intention of fleeing from the battlefield, that there is no one that is protecting our houses. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا هِيَ بِعَوْرَةٍ, that their houses were not, there was no threat that was put on their houses, and their houses were safeguarded. All they wanted to do was to flee from the battlefield. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that when you teaches us in this portion of the Quran, that as believers, when we are believers, we become believers in the true sense of the word, and not just as an act or a facade or just, to show people that we're believers. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala too, you know, gives us an example of the true believers in this portion of the Quran. And that was through the example of none other than the mother of the believers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention, regarding them, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was told to give them the ultimatum. And this happened, the incident that transpired, that they asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam for an increase. And the increase was just so they could have a little bit in the house that they can eat and they can nourish themselves through. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, told the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to give them the ultimatum, that if they want this worldly life, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can give them this worldly life, but then they can no longer stay with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And subhanallah, each and every one of them chose the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and chose to stay with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So we ask ourselves that the brother of the believers were not asking for much. They were just asking for something basic that they can nourish themselves in their houses. Yet, why were they given the ultimatum? And the reason being, the ulama mentioned that they were put on a pedestal, and their sacrifice, hence, had to be the greatest sacrifice. Their sacrifice cannot be any ordinary sacrifice. If they were to be an example for the entire ummah until the day of judgment, their sacrifice has to be the greatest. And this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told them to give them the ultimatum. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us the understanding. Jazakumullahu khair. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.